Well, the new DVD that I've been looking at is a new Quick Licks DVD, and we're looking at the style of the legendary blues guitar player Stevie Ray Vaughan. Basically, on this DVD, we're looking at licks that work over a 12-bar blues in the key of E. We're going around the blues five times, so 60 bars in total. And we're looking at all of the kind of licks and tricks that he would use, and also look at some of the scales he would use as well, blues scales, pentatonic scales, and you know, things that will make you stylistically sound quite, hopefully quite Texan. Well, the Quick Licks differs from the other Stevie Ray Vaughan products that I've looked at because we're not actually analysing full songs. On the other Learn to Play DVDs, I looked at classic Stevie Ray tracks and transcribed them on the DVD note for note. Whereas this DVD is more stylistic, so I teach you licks and I show you the techniques that he would have incorporated into his playing so that you can hopefully take that away and, you know, make that part of your own playing style. The thing that's so special, I think, about Stevie Ray was his phrasing. A lot of those climbing string bends where he you know, goes up a fret at a time but gradually pushes the bend. A lot of big first finger bends. He used huge strings as well on his guitar. There's all those kind of the sort of folklore about him, you know, sticking his fingers to his arm with glue and then pulling it off to get new fingertips. There's all manner of strange, I don't know how true those stories are, but he was just a very gutsy, raw guitar player, and no one could play a Texan shuffle like Stevie Ray. You know, he could do that really, you know, slow grooving triplet shuffle, or he could do the really fast, fast style shuffle. He was also listening to you know, things like Scuttlebutting, where he's doing those incredibly fast, sort of chicken picking, almost country inspired licks. So to me, he's the kind of, you know, the top draw when it comes to blues guitar player. I think probably the best advice I could give to a guitar player when watching this DVD is going to be spot up on your scales and your pentatonic scales and your blues scales. Work on your tone. He didn't have a particularly dirty sound. It was more of a, you know, the amps driving and doing their thing. And also, you know, look at the pitch of string bends, experiment with different techniques with your fingers, as opposed to just always using the pick. The string bends, though, is the main thing that I would say concentrate on, you know, looking at the first finger bends. But those would be the areas that I would suggest that someone, you know, looked at when they were looking at this DVD. Very pleased with the sound of the DVD, i.e. the backing track, and I think we captured again some of that Texan style and tone.